Hello there, welcome to Ms. RedNebula's PlanCo Tips, Thememaker's Toolkit Edition. I'm one of those people who loves the creative building aspects of Planet Coaster, and I have a long wish list of items I'd love to see added to the game. When the Thememaker's Toolkit was announced, I decided to learn Blender so I could bring my wish list to life. 3D software can look a little intimidating at first, but no matter your skill level, you can learn to make simple objects like signs with ease. And maybe it'll spark your interest to take your own 3D modeling to the next level. This will be a series of tutorials showing you how to create objects in Blender to upload to the Thememaker's Toolkit and use in your Planet Coaster parks. Blender is an extremely powerful, open-source 3D modeling software, and best of all, it's completely free to use. First off, let's go over how to download Blender and get it set up to work with the toolkit. As of this recording, we're working with Blender version 2.79b. I'm aware that there are big changes coming with version 2.80, which is in beta at the moment, but for now, let's focus on the current version. Head over to www.blender.org to download and install Blender. When you first open it up, you'll see a scene set up with a cube, a camera, and a light, along with several menus. I'll go over what you need to know for my tutorial specifically, but there are already some fantastic videos out there detailing all you need to know about Blender's interface, so I don't want to rehash that here. Check out the tutorials on Surface Studios or Blender Guru. I recommend watching both, starting with Surface Studios. He goes over both where to find things in the interface and the shortcut keys, while Blender Guru mainly relies on shortcuts. However, Blender Guru touches on a few things that were missing from the Surface Studios video. I'll link them both in the description below. To start with, there are a few settings we need to change in order for this to work best with the Thememaker's toolkit. First, go to the dropdown at the top of the page where it says Blender Render, and change this to Cycles Render. It's just a more powerful rendering engine for when you're previewing your work. Then, let's get rid of the objects in the scene. They're mostly in the way at this point. Select the camera by right-clicking it, and then press either the X key or the Delete key on your keyboard. Confirm the delete by pressing Enter, then do the same thing for the light. We're going to keep the cube for just a few minutes so I can demonstrate some things. Next, go to the Scene tab, the little icon with three objects on it. The Thememaker's toolkit measures objects in meters, so here we can tell Blender to use these real-world measurements. Next to Length, click the dropdown and choose Metric. Then, next to Unit Scale, change the number to 0.01. This adjusts the scale to centimeters rather than meters, which works best with the uploader. Next, open the Properties panel. You can do this by hovering your mouse over the main view and pressing N, or by clicking the small plus sign in the top right corner of this view. Note that you can see some very useful information about your object in this panel: its location, rotation, scale, and dimensions. This stuff will be very important later on, so remember how to get here. Now you can see that your cube is pretty small at 2 centimeters, and the grid on the view is huge by comparison. Since we changed the scale to centimeters, we're zoomed really far into a very small object. Let's fix that. Select the cube by right-clicking on it, then zoom way out by scrolling your mouse wheel until you can see the grid again. Also note that you can pivot your view by holding down the mouse wheel button and moving around. Make the cube bigger by clicking Scale in the Tools menu or simply by pressing S on your keyboard. You can then scale by dragging your mouse. Note how it keeps moving across the screen as long as you're in scale mode. Or if you want to be more precise, you can just type in a number. Type 100, and note that you can see what you typed in the bottom left corner of the view. Press Enter or click the mouse button to finalize the scale. You can also move the object around by choosing Translate or pressing the G key to grab it. And you can rotate the object by choosing Rotate or by pressing the R key. You can lock any of these modes to an axis by pressing that axis's button, X, Y, or Z. For example, press R and then X, and your rotation will lock to the X axis. take a look in the Properties window and see that, while the dimensions now correctly say you've got a 2-meter cube, the scale is at 100 and the rotation is off as well. If you tried to upload this object into the toolkit, you'd get an error that it's too small, because right now, Blender is just showing you a 2-centimeter cube magnified 100 times. You always want the scale to be at a value of all 1, and the rotation to be at a value of all 0 before you export. It's an easy fix, though. With the cube selected, go to the Object menu, Apply, and then click Rotation and Scale. Now you have a correctly scaled and rotated 2-meter cube. One more quick fix. See how the grid disappears toward the top edge of the screen? To fix that, go into the Properties under Clip and change the end value to 100m. Note that you have to type the m at the end to tell it meters, otherwise it will assume you mean 100 centimeters, and then you won't be able to see much at all. That's everything we need the cube for, so go ahead and delete it. Now, since you don't want to have to do this every time you open Blender, you can save this as your new startup file. Go up to the File menu and click Save Startup File. Click again to confirm. You can make any changes you want and then save the startup file to keep them. Or if you just want it to be back the way it was, go to File and Load Factory Settings to get back to the way Blender comes by default and save that as your startup. The last part of this video is a quick overview of how to position your object and which settings to use when exporting for the toolkit. You won't need this until you're ready to export your scene, but I wanted to cover it in this video. When you have a finished object like we'll be creating later in this series, you'll first need to rotate it so that the top of the object is facing toward the y-axis. The y-axis is green, and you can tell which way is forward by looking at the widget's green arrow or at this indicator down in the lower left corner of the view. Whichever side of your object is in this direction will be facing up when placed on the ground in Planet Coaster, or facing outward if placed against a wall. If you make any changes to the rotation or scale of your object, always remember to select it and apply the rotation and scale. In fact, this is a great habit to get into just before exporting your file anyway. When you're ready to export your file, go to File, Export, and choose FBX. For the version, choose FBX 6.1 ASCII, and for the forward direction, choose Y forward. Make sure it's the Y forward without the negative sign in front of it. You'll notice the up direction also changes to Z up. Finally, if your object is static, deselect the animation checkbox. If it's a moving object, you'll leave this checked. Now you're ready to save the file. Note that as of this recording, the Thememaker's Toolkit user guide says you only need to rotate the object in this way if it's animated, but I've found it needs to be done regardless of whether it's animated or not. That's it for the setup. In the next video, we'll start on a simple sign that you'll be able to import into Planet Coaster using the Thememaker's Toolkit. In any case, that's all for today. Feel free to like or comment, and if you want random updates from my Planet Coaster exploits, subscribe. If you enjoy what I do and are interested in supporting the channel, check out my Patreon. In addition to helping me out, you can also get fun perks like voting on future projects or being the first to see new videos. That's all for now. Bye!